And just into the KMBC 9 newsroom, the fire department released the official report on the deadly explosion and fire at JJ's restaurant on the plaza. The report claims the staff did not put out the pilot lights on the kitchen stoves or water heater in the moments before the blast. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has more. Michael?
Len, that information that the pilot lights were left on the restaurant stove and the water heaters, the new information that's coming out of this report that was released this afternoon. On February 19th, JJ's exploded. It was destroyed. One woman died. Several others were injured. Blast happened at 6:04 on a Tuesday night. According to the fire investigators' report, the firefighters went into JJ's after the leak was reported. This is before the explosion. At the time, the restaurant was filled with a strong smell of natural gas. The report says the fire department asked the manager on duty to put out the flames on the restaurant's candles, on the stove, and the water heater. The investigator, Thomas Cleveland's report states, I asked him if they got all the flames out, and he said they only put the candles out and turned off the stove, but did not turn off the pilots for the stove or the water heater. The cover statement to the report says the explosion and fire was caused by natural gas vapors that accumulated inside JJ's restaurant. Hostess Megan Kramer's body was found near the bar. The report says she was trying to escape as she died. The report also says when the Missouri Gas Energy officials arrived on the scene to deal with the leak, they told Fire Truck 19's crew they had it under control and that the firefighters could leave, which they did. So the new information out from the fire department report about the JJ's fire, that the management was told to extinguish all the flames, the candles, the pilot lights on the stove, and the water heater. The candles went out, but the pilot lights stayed on. And so latest from here, back to you.
All right, thank you, Michael. The larger investigation as to who, if anybody, is to blame is underway right now. It's being conducted by the Missouri Public Service Commission.